Y'all, so check this video out.
What's wrong with you?
What are you talking about?
What you mean what I'm talking about? You know what
I'm talking about?
Why you quit your job?
Because I wasn't finna pay bills anymore. I don't wanna do any of this anymore.
What you mean you're not finna pay bills no more?
I'm not paying any bills anymore. Like, are you hard of hearing? Like, so, I'm not doing it anymore.
So you're not gonna help me out no more?
Oh.
Why?
Because that's your job. You're supposed to be paying all the bills in the first place. Why I gotta go work? Why I gotta get up at 8 o'clock?
Who house is this?
It's our house, but you gonna pay all these bills. I'm not doing it by myself.
I'm saying, so what wrong with you working to help
them? There's a lot wrong with it. Why I gotta do it? Why I gotta do it? You sit up here and act like you the man of the house. Okay, be the man of the house and pay all the bills. I'm not doing it.
I am the man of the house.
No, you're not. No, you're not. Not complaining like that.
No, I'm the man of the house. The man of the house telling you you need to.
No, I'm not going to go do anything. I'm going to continue to do what I'm doing right here on my computer, and you go to work.
What you doing on the computer, y'all?
You know the kids. Be a man. Step up and do what you need to do.
I've always been a man.
No, you're not. No, you're not. You don't haven't been lately.
I've always been a man.
You sure haven't been lately.
How?
So what? You
how?
Bring this camera in my face to do what?
How?
What point are you trying to prove?
To show people how sorry you is.
I'm not sorry. I'm not sorry. What I'm going to do is be the lady in the house and make sure the house is taken care of, and you go out and work. How come I don't? Did you just eat last night?
What the?
Did you just eat last night?
Anymore.
Now you can go work at your little warehouse job and listen, bring back that money so listen, we can pay these bills.
Cooking Rotel ain't no.
What you talking about? We're not even talking about me cooking. What we talking about is you going to work so you can come back home and make sure that we good.
No. What we talking about is you need to go get a job so you can
no,
help
I'm
make sure
we good. No, I'm not
going to
do anything. I'm not about to do anything. If you not satisfied.
No, we need to help make sure we each other good. So like,
no, I'm good. I'm good. You need to make sure that this whole house is
you good.
Yeah, I'm good.
How you good if you just quit your job?
Because you don't know what I got put up. But at the end of the day, like I said, I'm not paying anything else.
Oh, so that's what we doing.
Like I said, I'm not paying anything else. And you're going to be responsible for everything else. I'm tired of paying bills. Simple as that. So what you want to do?
Bro, that little portion you put in on
portion?
That little portion.
Okay, so my little portion about nothing because I'm not paying anything else.
And that's the problem.
You're not understanding that.
I don't understand why you don't think that's a problem.
It isn't a problem.
So
I'm your wife. I'm your wife. So why do you want your wife to go out and work? I'm not understanding it.
Plenty of people wives work.
Okay, I'm not going to be one of them anymore. Simple as that.
No.
You need to step your game up. Go get you another job. Go get 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 more if you got to. But
two,
I'm not going to do it no more.
You got me.
I do not.
Nah, you got
go
me.
Go being lazy. Stop being a bum.
Nah.
And go get another job.
Nah. What you can do is you can get up off
the
get you
anything.
Another job because you quit
no,
a job.
I'm straight. At the end of the day, you may need to go get you another job and take care of these bills. We got four kids and you can't even barely take care of one.
Whoa. So apparently he's not bringing home enough money, so you need to help. You his partner, right? What happened to these marriages? It's like this chick said, I quit. I'm not working no more. Forget these bills. You got it.
Now, first and foremost, whether you want to be a traditional woman, have fun. Whether you want to be a woman who goes to work and you're a boss babe, have fun. Whatever works for you, do that. It's my opinion. If you don't like it, keep it pushing. I find it very crazy that women will say that they're super logical but make decisions like this lady. You have four mouths to feed and you decided to quit your job without letting your partner know. Partner means you guys are together, means you have to run it by your partner. You could have sat that man down. Babe, I'm overwhelmed. I cannot do it anymore. My mental health is literally so compromised. I don't feel like I'm going to be okay. Can I quit my job? So that way he knows what he has to do. You just randomly quit your job. Now you put all this extra stress on your relationship for no reason. And here's my other thing. I understand why women want to stay home and not work. That's how it's been since the dawn of time. Yo, I was raised in a Hispanic household. Men go out and work. Women stay home, cook and clean. But the one thing about my family is the women still worked because they wanted to. They didn't have to. But the thing that trips me out about a lot of women in today's society is when a man does work 2-3 jobs, what do? Get mad that you don't get enough attention. Get mad that when he comes home, he just wants to sleep and not play with the kids. You're making a man work 2-3 jobs like he's supposed to, but then expect all this other stuff after. No matter what, I've noticed a big pattern. Women will always complain. I'm not blaming you guys, but I've noticed that when you don't work, some women are happy, flourishing, whatever, but you still complain that the man's not home all the time, or he works too much, or he doesn't play with the kids. Then when a man doesn't do those things, he's considered a bum. Like, though, her wording to her partner that's supposed to be her man is crazy. Telling somebody they're not man enough isn't going to make the situation better. Belittling me when you're quitting your job is not going to make the relationship any better. Now, I understand why women want a lot of things that they do, and nobody should take that from you. I feel like every woman should be taken care of, especially if they're an old school traditional woman. But to me, I'm sorry, a lot of people aren't traditional, and it's not just women, it's women and men. And a lot of y'all, you guys don't talk about these things. You know what I mean? Like, y'all will get with people and then have kids, get married and all this stuff, and then later down the line, these are the problems you're having. If you get with a guy who's traditional already, you wouldn't be having this argument. And like him, he wants a girl clearly who's gonna go and work and stuff. Is he wrong for that? Again, you guys marry guys that don't fit your lifestyle. So like for me, I don't care whether a guy's traditional or 50-50. I got YouTube money. I'm not tripping. I'm not broke or none of that stuff. So if a guy was to come into my life, I purely just want love and somebody to take care of my heart and soul. I don't need your fucking money. But if you want to buy me stuff and take care of me, that's fine. But again, you have to state those things so guys know that and make sure you're attracting the right type of man. You women will attract men that don't want to be traditional. Or you'll get with men who are super young, grew up in more of a Gen Z generation, who don't believe in traditional. They believe in 50-50 equality. And then you expect them to have this traditional mindset. That's what makes me laugh about a lot of women in today's society. They will get mad and yell. You can look at the comment section to this video. They will sit there and say, oh, men of this generation, they're so sassy. Men of this generation aren't men anymore. These are the men y'all created. These are the men y'all wanted, and you guys wanted this 50-50 equality stuff. So how can you be mad that this has now backfired on you guys? I think a lot of the women who did the Me Too movement, screaming and doing all that extra stuff, you guys should have just shut up while you could. I'm being so honest. Because now when you have men that want to go 50-50 and say, okay, you're equal, you make just as much money as I do, you can go out there and work, you have privilege, you have rights now. Like I said, I believe in traditional relationships, so if you want to get taken care of, that's perfectly fine. But when you look at the bigger picture here, a lot of y'all have ruined the dating game and don't even understand why. It wasn't like this not too long ago, y'all, if you don't remember. I don't know what kind of relationships y'all have been in, but I would never, ever want to be with somebody where we're arguing about money. That's one of my biggest pet peeves, because to me, money has always came and gone. It's something that's the root of all evil. I'm not arguing about money. But if you come to me and tell me your mental health is compromised, you want to quit your job, I'm your partner. I'm supposed to have your back. And I will do that if you need to, whether you're a guy or a girl. But I just find it weird that, like, people want to be married but don't want to help out when they're married. I feel like for me, if I was in a relationship with somebody and say I was working a normal job, I'm not going to quit my job because I have four kids. I'm pretty smart. So I'd probably get on social media, start drop shipping, start doing affiliate marketing, start finding ways to make money online. Y'all will complain and bitch about working, but there's so many ways to make money online. You know that? It trips me out that people can sit on their phones all day long but not know how to make money from social media. And I'm not saying that to brag. This is why I wanted to do social media. Because if I ever do get in a relationship with a traditional man or 50-50, I'm sitting on money. So if I'm with a guy and, you know, shit hits the fan for him, or say I have kids and he dies or gets cancer or something happens or whatever, guess what I can fall on? I'm a stay-at-home mom and a YouTuber on the side. So I'm still making money from home. I don't even have to leave the house. Like I said, you take that information however you want, and I'm all about women working and doing what they got to do and feeling happy, but dude, it's a partnership. It's not all about you, and sometimes you have to make sacrifices. That's your family. I'd be damned if I was the type of woman to ever say, I'm quitting my job when I got four mouths to feed. Now, if it was me and my partner, cool, I get it, but four kids, you wish. I get some type of like kickstart in me to hustle. There's no way in my life I could ever do that. And like I said, y'all, I grew up in poverty. I grew up in nothing. So I would never want my kids to grow up in half of the shit I ever did. Arguing over money, fights, things like that. Like, I don't know, y'all. Y'all need to pack it up and get your guys' stuff together. Stop marrying people too soon. Talk about these things first. And if you decide you want to be a traditional woman, traditional man, state that. Stop telling guys, I'll work all this, all that, to get approval from them. Just say you want traditional stuff and that's it. If they don't meet that requirement, baby, find your king. Find your queen. Sayonara, baby.